Hey there, it's Tisha, and it has been a little while since my convo and my Camry, but here we are with another one. Been out of town, been on vacation, been unplugging, definitely for the summer. And I have been giving it a lot of thought, and I actually announced this just last week in my gals group, but this whole concept of when is it time to move on and let go? When is it time when what you're doing is not challenging you anymore and maybe needs a change or maybe needs a facelift? And I decided not too long ago that it was time. It was time for me to let a big part of my business go. Some of you know that I run a women's group here in Arizona and virtually called the Gals Inspiration Hub. And I've been posting about it, sharing it, women in the group, members and such. And after 9 years of hosting women's mastermind groups, first with Mompreneurs Live and then the Mommy Club and then Gals Inspiration Hub, I decided that it was time to hang up the towel and let it go and move on and open myself up to some new opportunities. And you can only grow if you're willing to make some changes, and whether they're uncomfortable or whether they're, you know, tough to make, it was time. It was time for me to make that decision and change it up a bit. And so as of July 1st, I'm no longer hosting the Gals Inspiration Hub meetings. I'm hosting some virtuals in June just to wrap up. And then I'm reimagining it. And I'm really thinking that what I need from that and what other women are looking for is not me marketing, promoting, sharing, creating the mastermind, facilitating. I have to think that for 9 years, I facilitated close to 300 meetings with women in business. And it's time to move on and open myself up to new opportunities. But just sharing that sometimes we have these, what my girlfriends are saying, these come to Jesus meeting. I'm pointing out Melinda and Cricket because they always say that to me. It's time to have a come to Jesus meeting. And really think about, when is it time to kind of reevaluate where you're at? And when is it time to move on? If something is not fulfilling you, if you're not getting excited about it anymore, that to me is a really great eye-opener that you need to reevaluate. Figure out what you're doing and be open to whatever new possibilities, new journeys there are ahead. And it was my time. 9 years, loved it, loved every minute of it, but it's time to move on from that and do happy hour instead and not have to stress so much about bringing group women together in this group and facilitating, but now just be a participant. There was this really great news article or news piece done the other day, and it was a gentleman here in Phoenix who, he's taking this choir to Sydney, Australia, and he was saying, this is my last performance to perform or to conduct this symphony and this choir. And I loved what he said. He's like, after this, I'm retiring. And I think I'm going to finally get to sing in the choir instead of conduct the choir. And that, I feel, is where I'm at too. Like, it's time to actually be a participant for once and not be the facilitator at everything I do, and to figure out what my next move is. So there you have it, convo in my Camry, and great to be back. And if you have any ideas or suggestions or questions on this topic, I'd love to start a conversation with you. So let me know. All right, thanks so much for listening.